Welcome to the Tropical Update. I'm Dave Schwartz. Before we check in on the current tropical scene, let's check in on the Wrath of Isidore. Isidore may have made landfall yesterday in Louisiana, but the Florida Panhandle felt the full effects of the storm. Santa Rosa Island is still dealing with the residual flooding. Tides 4 to 7 feet above average helped bury streets in sand and make some roads hard to drive through. The Santa Rosa Island Authority reports that while structural damage is at a minimum, Isidore did cause some major beach erosion. Officials say it may be 1 or 2 more days before a damage assessment is complete. Well, Isidore is no more. It's a low pressure system moving into Vermont at the present time, whipping up a lot of wind, surging tropical moisture in as far as north as Boston right now, and that'll be offshore later on tonight, and that will be that. It'll just be a windy day in New England tomorrow. Here's the next tropical system that we are keeping a close eye on. Why? Because it's moving toward the United States, that's why. Here's the island of Bermuda, and the center of the circulation, or the eye of Kyle, is 440 miles south-southeast of Bermuda, but it's moving west-southwest at 5 miles an hour. So that brings it closer to the Bahamas and the United States. The forecast for this, though, is that it weakens due to some strong northwesterly, northeasterly winds. That should shear it apart, at least for the time being, and the circulation center will be exposed. There won't be any showers near the circulation center, so it should undergo a weakening phase for the next day or two. If there's anything left of it as it continues to move west, a possible strengthening as it heads toward the Gulf Stream. That's Hurricane Kyle. Here's Tropical Storm Lili, also moving in a westerly direction, north-northwest, that latest check at 8 miles an hour, but that also brings it closer to the United States. In the short term, this is a major problem for residents of Jamaica, right here, and also Cuba and Haiti, also in line for a coast, a surge of some high seas on the south-facing beaches here on the south coast and some very heavy rain. Now, we believe that both of these systems will continue to move in a westward fashion because there's a big ridge of high pressure here. Notice the turning of the clouds? Big ridge of high pressure, and that's going to stay in place for a little while till this trough begins to move across the United States. But this should push everything generally in the tropics from east to west. That's why we are concerned early and middle next week that both of these systems could be a problem. Here's a close-up on Lili right now. Tropical Storm Lili, as it moves slowly toward the north-northwest, still rather disorganized, but still there'll be some very heavy rain as this moves into Jamaica later on tonight and tomorrow, where tropical storm warnings are in effect. Also parts of Cuba. You know, Isidore smacked western Cuba. It looks like Lili gets eastern Cuba, and maybe the whole island, as this continues toward the west-northwest through Sunday and Monday. And there's a new tropical disturbance southwest of the Cape Verde Islands that could develop into another tropical storm. So it's pretty active out here. Time to come back stateside for your forecast for Saturday. That's coming up.
Evening Edition is sponsored by Baymont Inns and Suites, rated best hotel value by Entrepreneur Magazine.
Inns and Suites. Worth checking into.
You're losing your hair. And you haven't ordered Avacor yet? You've heard all about Avacor on radio for years. Now we've brought it to TV, so you can see our successful results with your own eyes.
Medical studies and the FDA have reported the body chemical dihydrotestosterone, commonly known as DHT, as the leading cause of hair loss. Avacor stops DHT from attacking your hair follicles and starts regrowing hair in balding areas. Avacor's DHT blocker is all natural, safe, and effective.
In 6 years of clinical use by tens of thousands of men and women, Avacor regrew hair on virtually everyone.
We guarantee it.
Join the thousands of satisfied men and women who have reversed their hair loss with Avacor. Call 800-291-5037. That's 800-291-5037. Now you can use Avacor risk-free for 3 full months. Call 800-291-5037.
Which is a classic example of return on investment. Perhaps you have an example, sir?
Certainly, a Dell PC. Allow me to demonstrate. A Dell Expert helps you get the right PC for you.
Add the powerful mobile Pentium 4 processor M.
Sweet.
Factor in award-winning service and support, and you get great value for minimum investment. Cost-benefit analysis would be redundant.
Impressive.
Not so fast, so talks a lot.
Call or go online now and get an Inspiron.
And thanks for joining us on Weekend Now on this Saturday morning. I'm meteorologist Mark Mancuso. I'll be joined by Kristen Dawe this morning. And in-house is our hurricane expert, Dr. Steve Lyons. He'll be briefing you throughout the morning what's happening in the tropics. Right now, here's your first peek at the tropics, and we'll show you what's going on here. And it looks like here we go again, another area of concern developing in the Caribbean and bearing down on Jamaica and Cuba. This could be a threat to the southeast U.S. and the Gulf of Mexico next week. So we're giving you the early heads up on it. This is the area of concern developing in the Caribbean, and its motion will be off towards west-northwest with time. North of here, here's another feature that's been hanging on tough. It's Kyle. Kyle, rather tenacious system in through here, still drifting its way off towards the west-southwest. South of here, a couple of waves moving out across the Atlantic, really not doing too much right now. And over the Lesser Antilles, weather pretty quiet. As we get you into the Caribbean, the Gulf of Mexico, we see tranquil conditions now, relatively speaking, in the Gulf. But in the Caribbean, we do see the area convection near and just east of Jamaica. And meanwhile, north of Puerto Rico, we do see Kyle. And off to the east of the Bahamas, Kyle just kind of sitting out there. As we show you Tropical Storm Lili, hurricane hunters were investigating overnight tonight, and they found winds up to 50 miles an hour in a very small area right near the center of circulation. So it's a tight circulation, so very close to the center, winds to 50. And the movement of this has just been kind of slowing down. The reason why the steering currents are presently of the system very weak. So the very weak steering currents is kind of drifting about, but it should kind of head its way slowly off towards the north-northwest over the next 12, 24 hours. Pressure was found to be about 999 millibars. So, tropical storm. There you can see our tropical storm warnings in the red, Jamaica, southern Cuba, and parts of Haiti. Tropical storm conditions probably occurring here on the southwest peninsula of Haiti. And in eastern Jamaica, we have seen an increase in rain and thunderstorms around Kingston, but very little wind. Farther west, we do see tropical storm watches. That means conditions favorable for tropical storm conditions in about 36 hours. That would include Little Cayman, Cayman Brac, not Grand Cayman, in parts of southern Cuba. Here's a close view of the satellite picture, and you can see the blobs of convection, no doubt, where we do have heavy rain occurring. So where you see these orange and red areas, that's where the heavy rain's coming down. You see the southwest part of that peninsula in Haiti there, probably seeing some tropical storm conditions. Now, just coming into eastern Jamaica, another round of heavy rain coming on in towards the Kingston area. So with these mountainous regions, they will be the threat for life-threatening mudslides and very heavy rains again. Here's the movement, very slow for today. Just kind of meandering, maybe drifting off towards the north-northwest. And then with time, high pressure building over the southeastern United States, this system will be shunted off towards the west-northwest. Question that arises is, will this kind of skim the south coast of Cuba, kind of drift its way north, and then get pushed along the north coast of Cuba off towards the west-northwest? But anyway you cut it, the system will be headed in the direction of the Gulf of Mexico by early next week. And conditions will be favorable for further strengthening of this feature into a hurricane. So that is something to ponder if you live in the southeast or on the Gulf Coast for next week. So plenty of time to watch it. And as we know, going back from the lessons learned from Isidore, a lot can happen. So that's why we want you to keep in touch. So here's our system in through here. Weak upper lows moved away. To the north, though, high pressure building in. And that will force this feature off to the west, northwest. North of here, what's that? Well, that is Kyle. Kyle just kind of easing its way off towards the west. Southwest is hanging tough. Barely a hurricane at winds of 75 miles an hour. It is encountering some northerly shear here. But there you can see the convection hanging tough. And the system well south of Bermuda. But around Bermuda, probably some increased well. And also down towards the Dominican Republic and also around the Puerto Rico. So here it is, our feature, Kyle. There's that big ridge up to the north. So this is probably just going to move very slowly off to the west, southwest next couple of days. So plenty of time to watch it if you live around the Bahamas or the east coast of the U.S. But the future of this feature, rather uncertain. Gulf of Mexico, not much happening in through here. East Pacific, pretty quiet. But we do have a typhoon in the far east, and that is moving through the Mariana Islands, passing well north of Guam.
When a weather disaster strikes, someone is always there to help. Project Safeside urges you to help families in need of disaster relief. Outback Steakhouse is a proud sponsor of Project Safeside, a national severe weather program. Now there's an easier way to see the world. Just visit Orbit.com. The only travel site featuring The Matrix, the easy way to find the low fares and options you want. Visit Orbit.com today, where finding the most low fares is easy.
Yep, this is going to be fun. An 8-hour flight with a screaming stiff neck. How about grabbing a Thermacare heat wrap? Open it up and put it on before your in-flight nap. It gets warm and stays warm for 8 hours. Deeply relaxing tight muscles. So circulation flows in, helping pain flow out. Hey, by the next time zone, you'll be upright and out of sight.
Yes.
All day long.
Bye-bye.
Thermacare heat wraps. Find them in the pain reliever aisle.
Expert, Dr. Steve Lyons with the latest. Steve?
Thanks, Mark, and we're looking at a very heavy rain producer today, and that's going to be the story for the next 24 to 30 hours over portions of the northern Caribbean islands. Let's look at the latest satellite imagery for Lili, and you can see the circulation spinning around there, basically just to the east of Jamaica and just to the southwest of Haiti, the circulation center roughly in there, and it could be reforming off into the thunderstorms off and on through the rest of the day. The circulation overall spinning around like this, and of course the big threat we see today is not the strong winds associated with it that currently are about 50 miles per hour, but the very heavy rain, and that heavy rain will be along this peninsula of Haiti over the next 24 to 30 hours. Of course, this isn't going to move much, so this whole area from over this area has to come all the way across before the rain stops over this peninsula. And keep in mind, there are some mountains here, not very high mountains, but fairly significant mountains. They're going to exacerbate the rainfall problem. So this is very likely to be flooded over the next 6 to 12 hours. So watch out if you're heading that way. Jamaica, the same way, we have winds out of the northeast right now, but the circulation we expect to move very close to that island and produce off and on heavy rain showers and localized flooding, possibility of mudslides in the higher elevations as well. Now, we currently have the latest information from the Hurricane Center. Winds 50 miles per hour. That's in a very small area near the circulation center, and those 50 mile per hour winds are not going to be all that damaging themselves, but the circulation is expected to strengthen over the next 72 hours. Pressure is 1,000 millibars right now, and we have warnings up in the red areas and watches up in the yellow areas. And as the system starts to move toward the west, west-northwest, we'll see those watches extend toward the west. Those of you in the Florida Keys and South Florida should be monitoring carefully the progress of this. We expect it to continue on toward the west, south of Cuba, through time, and in about 72 hours be right here. So the heavy rain spreading toward Cuba over the next 24 hours as it starts to make its move. Tropical Storm Kyle was a hurricane for many days. It's been out spinning around for a number of days now, heading to the west, southwest, now moving to the west at 7. The good news here is it's being decapitated by northeasterly wind shear. You can see the center peeking out from under the thunderstorms. That's a sign of at least temporary weakening. And so we expect only some high surf along the northern Caribbean islands and into the northeastern portions of the islands of the Bahamas as well. Out across the Atlantic itself, we're looking at one other low pressure system and a relatively well-defined tropical wave off the African coast. Keep in mind, we still have about 25% of the hurricane season left on average. So go out into the eastern Pacific, quiet. If you're heading to the Mexican Riviera down here, expect an isolated thunderstorm in the afternoon, but we're in great shape there. So with that, let's get some more weather with Mark.
All right, thank you very much, Dr. Steve Lyons. And of course, Dr. Lyons will keep us updated on future developments of Lili. Today, if you're going to be an outdoor enthusiast in the central and southern Rockies, be prepared for thunderstorms. Where you see the orange, we do think there will be scattered storms today. And that could be affecting some of these games in the Big 12 country this afternoon. Meanwhile, to the south in Florida and the west coast, we do think afternoon thunderstorms could erupt. Looking at the rainfall for today, nothing like what we have seen, but I do think the heavier downpours will be cutting across Minnesota as we are looking at a surge of heavy rains now coming out of East River, South Dakota. In the northeast, it's all over except the shouting and the gusts of the wind, as what's left of Isidore is now quickly exited through the Canadian Maritimes. Trailing front now passing south of southern New England. Skies are clearing out with a gusty northwesterly wind. In the southeast here, the front having a hard time making its move through the coastal areas, the Carolinas. Activity offshore over the Gulf Stream. And here comes that rain area headed east towards the Twin Cities.
In the 90 years L.L. Bean has sold outdoor clothing and gear, competitors have come and gone. Many have tried, but none have matched our dedication to quality and service. As others fold or merge, L.L. Bean remains family-owned and true to doing things right. Today, our commitment to quality products, service, and our guarantee assures you'll always be 100% satisfied. You have our word on it. Call today for our free catalog.
Walgreens has thousands of locations across America. From the corner of Elm and Main to the corner of Montgomery and Pine to our newest location, Walgreens.com. You can manage your health care on America's healthiest website because America's favorite corner drugstore is now located on the corner of your desk. Register online or come into Walgreens Pharmacy and we'll do it for you. Walgreens.com. Another reason Walgreens is the pharmacy America trusts.
These are my kids. They're at that age where their tastes change constantly. They're all such individuals. But with Campbell's tomato soup, I can make a lunch that keeps up with them. I add what each one loves. Salsa, sour cream, or shredded cheese. As different as they are, they do like the same thing for lunch. They just want to have it their own way.
Customize your soup with Campbell's, also in ready to serve.
Now there's an easier way to see the world. Just visit Orbit.com. The only travel site featuring The Matrix. The easy way to find the low fares and options you want. Visit Orbit.
And it's now 10 minutes till the top of the hour. You know that means it's time for your tropical weather update. There's a lot to update you on. Let's get started. I'm Lisa Moser. We're looking at Kyle. Kyle is drifting a little too close to comfort here. Now, we're not likely to see very much in the way of rainfall on those extreme southern cloud tops associated with Kyle. But we'll watch, and I'll tell you more about Kyle in just a moment. But that's Kyle. Here, very close to Jamaica and the island of Cuba here, and also it's raining down over much of Haiti, we are looking at a tropical storm, Tropical Storm Lili. Tropical Storm Lili so far taking a path that's very similar to Isidore. Remember Isidore? Let's give you the latest on Tropical Storm Lili. Now, we've not seen very much in the way of change with Lily for today. Still packing maximum sustained wind at 50 miles per hour. The movement at times has been stationary today, still pretty slow, and that makes Lily a big rainmaker. It's moving to the northwest now at about 3 miles per hour. Lowest estimated pressure as of 5 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, about 1,003 millibars. Now, there are a number of advisories posted, and we're likely to see additional advisories, especially for the Cayman Islands and also central Cuba as we go into tomorrow. Right now, all of Jamaica under a tropical storm warning, and so is much of Haiti along the western shoreline and the eastern area of Cuba also under a tropical storm warning. So let's take a look at some of those very impressive cloud tops associated with Tropical Storm Lili. You can see that where we've had some of those higher cloud top bands, that's likely where we've had some of the heavier rainfall for today. You'll also notice we're still seeing some impressive cloud tops over much of Haiti, but overall it looks like the clouds have been weakening a bit. And of course, when we see a tropical storm impacting a large landmass, that's generally what does happen. But that energy is not likely to go anywhere anytime soon. And of course, if it does cross over the island of Cuba as we get into Tuesday, it's very likely to be in a very favorable environment for further strengthening. Of course, we've got several days for it to graze along the shoreline of Cuba. Not good news, especially for the western areas of Cuba, because you may recall this time last week, Isidore, even once Isidore was well to the west of the island of Cuba, it was a big rainmaker for the area, and they are still dealing with flooding problems that were associated with Isidore. Not a very nice picture that we're painting here. But again, let me draw your attention a little further to the north of the Caribbean, where we have Tropical Storm Kyle. Now, you may recall we've been talking about Kyle for about 2 weeks now. Yesterday, this was a hurricane, so it did weaken some. Looking at maximum sustained wind at 60 miles per hour is south-southeast of Bermuda by about 385 miles. Lowest estimated pressure, 997 millibars. If it drifts a little further southward, occasionally we could be looking at some of those outer bands, bring some rain showers to Puerto Rico and maybe even the Bermuda area. So this is worth watching, although for the most part, the history of Kyle has not impacted a landmass. It's been out in the Atlantic, and of course it is a marine concern and still poses that threat for the mariners. Well, looking at the bigger picture, and you can notice that some of those colder cloud tops have been right along the core of and very close to the circulation, and that of course gives us a very favorable dynamic in place that we could still see some strengthening of Kyle, although the last 24 hours it's experienced some weakening. Out towards the Pacific we go, along the extreme southern areas of Mexico around Acapulco. There are some showers that those cloud tops do concern us, but right now we're not seeing any organization, and that is good news. Well, we will continue to keep you posted on the details in the Caribbean as well as back home at the top of the hour. Stay with us.
Tired of playing the mortgage rate game? You know, when you hear one of those ads that promise you the moon and you call up only to find out that the points are too high and there are hidden fees attached? Well, at ditech.com, there are no games. Right now, we're offering a second mortgage with a no closing cost option. You can be pre-qualified over the telephone or online. Use the money to pay off credit cards or for home improvements, whatever you want. Do it now before the rates go up. ditech.com. Call 1-800-71-FIXED.
The Revolution Massaging Showerhead from Moen. You've never felt water do this before. Create the perfect shower when you get water to spin, twist, and twirl. It will reinvent your whole day. The Revolution Massaging Showerhead from Moen. Buy it for looks, buy it for life.
Body pain? Oh. Back pain? Introducing new Bare Back and Body. It's Bare Aspirin plus a special pain relief enhancer to relieve sore backs and soothe aching muscles fast. New Bare Back and Body. Get moving again pain-free.
Share your day. Share your laughs. Share more time together with the whole family this fall with Verizon Wireless. Sign up now on the America's Choice National Family Share Plan and get unlimited nights and weekends to share on up to four separate lines. Hurry in and get extra anytime mobile-to-mobile minutes. And buy one Kia Seraphone for $49.99 and get a second free. So now there's no limit to how much you can share with all your loved ones. Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you.
Can you hear me now? Good.